We got these 14 frogs in very, very bad conditions, malnourished, with skin problems. So our first goal was to help them survive. In June, approximately 2019, a group of scientists went to the north of our country and found that the pond where the water loa frog lived was almost dry. So what they did was to take as many as frogs they could capture. They captured 60 and they moved them to another pond nearby, but they were concerned about the survival of this species, since this species live only in that pond in the north part of our country. So they managed to go again and capture all the frogs they could find and thought about us, the National Zoo of Chile, to get some hope for the species, to make some ex situ management and reproduction. And as a zoo, we heard about this huge, huge commitment and challenge in a 48-hour notice. So what we did is that we called the minister and asked him to help the frogs to travel to Santiago by a plane in the cockpit, not in the cargo area, since we didn't know if the frogs were going to survive. We made it, and even the pilots told all the passengers that they were carrying this very important passenger, these 14 passengers in the plane. So we were very happy, very concerned, and accepting this challenge willingly. We had all the knowledge to captive breed amphibians, native amphibians, since we have a lot of other conservation programs about different species. We had to mimic the water conditions up north. It's the driest desert in the world, so has a very specific salinity, pH, etc. The other challenge was the food. We needed to feed these frogs, and we didn't have all the insects that that they are used to up north. So we tried to try different insects and different diets, and they were not eating by themselves. So we had to get each frog every day and force feed them. Fortunately, everything went very, very well. We have now 12 frogs alive of the 14. The two ones that were in the worst conditions didn't survive. But we're very happy because after a year and a couple of months, a year and 2 months, we were noticing that some of the individuals had reproductive conditions, like this skin patch on males, and some females were a little bit chubby. So we put two couples together, and we got about 200 eggs. At the beginning, we didn't know if the eggs were fertile or not, but we noticed right away that these eggs turn into larvae very, very fast. And everything that we are getting now, it's new for science. This is the first time that this particular species is reproduced in an ex situ condition. And of course, the goal is to put these future generations of water loa frogs back into the wild, into their habitat. But unfortunately, this habitat was almost lost because of water extraction by mining, human settlements that were nearby, stealing water from these very scarce ponds that are up north in the desert. So this huge effort of the National Zoo is not worth it if nothing is done with the habitat issue. Something that is happening nowadays and is that the area, the habitat where these frogs live is going to be a sanctuary of nature, that it's a protected area, so all the threats are going to disappear in this protected area. So that's amazing news for this species. We'll keep going to breed. Now we have another two couples together. So, and the habitat is going to be preserved. So there's a future for this species.
Mongabay.